Welcome back to NetApp INSIGHT 2025 in Las Vegas. I'm Christophe, Bertrand, Principal Analyst with theCUBE Research. I'm very, very pleased to have a technology conversation with Sandeep Singh, who is the SVP and GM of the Enterprise Storage. Big day for you.
It is a blockbuster day for not only just NetApp, but across all of our customers and partners. You know, we just introduced the NetApp AFX, and the AI data engine. And while we've been accelerating customers' AI workloads across hundreds of customers for many years with NVIDIA, these two introductions just changed the game entirely.
Exactly, and we're talking about a data platform now. That suddenly got my attention in the keynote. So from your standpoint, obviously you're very focused on the products and making sure you have the right products and the right solutions in place for your customers as we're literally navigating difficult times with finding ROI in AI and over-investing maybe at times, but maybe not. So what are the type of requirements that you've observed from your customers? What are they expecting from you? And what do you think will make a big difference in the end?
Yeah, look, first of all, AI just has just this tremendous potential for every organization. And every organization is currently looking at how do they gain an AI advantage across the board, whether it's productivity gains, delivering net new experiences, or just finding net new overall business models or revenue streams. Fundamentally, AI, especially in the enterprise, is a data problem. Data is the fuel for AI. And as customers are looking at starting on their AI journey, the first challenge becomes what is the right infrastructure that to support their AI initiatives. But very quickly, it's about how do I get my AI or data AI ready? And this is where customers need not only the performance and the scale at the infrastructure level, they need all of the enterprise-grade capabilities. This is about secure multi-tenancy so that they can have their overall AI centers of excellence and feed multiple data teams or agentic AI in the future. This is about having this data mobility so that data, wherever it sits, can be made accessible to the GPUs without creating copies and while preserving all of the security permissions. This is about having the ability to seamlessly have on-premises and cloud stitched together. AI is inherently a hybrid cloud workflow.
Right.
There's a ton of innovation that's happening in the public cloud tied to AI. And yet customers' data is sitting on-prem, and you need to be able to combine those. And lastly, AI thrives on data, but data has to be fundamentally secure.
Right.
So you need all of the security that enterprises count on. That's what customers are asking us about, and this is why it's so exciting to have the AFX and AI data engine.
Right, and lots of challenges that you've covered here in a nutshell, but our research here, theCUBE research, shows that cyber resiliency is definitely in need of more work across the board, as well as the need to protect nascent AI infrastructure and yet leveraging AI itself in the process of management, governance, and data protection. So maybe we can touch on the two sides of the coin in a second. So you mentioned that data has to be good, it has to be trusted, it has to be resilient. So if we think about the big topics here, data management and data classification, lots of silos today, big challenge. Cyber resiliency, data resilience, whatever term we want to use.
Yes.
I'm going to say even maybe bigger challenge because now the attackers are AI powered themselves. And then you have to take a look at the evolution of AI itself from an infrastructure standpoint, as you pointed out. This is not your HPC workflows of the past. It's not just a bunch of databases. It's not just unstructured data or file systems. It's a very different animal. So let's double click on the AFX, and it makes me smile when I hear the term disaggregation, because when I started in this business, 25 years ago or so, there was a startup called NetApp that came up with that disaggregation concept. Now, very different world, no question about that. But walk us through this, and why is it so different and so critical that you are doing it this way?
Yeah, look, fundamentally, over the years, NetApp in its 30-year history has had multiple innovation waves as the technology has continued to evolve. NetApp has innovated on behalf of our customers. It began with the filer of just a simplified overall appliance. Then it shifted to virtualization was the key, you know, overall technology wave. And we partnered with VMware and enabled for customers just to have a super seamless, scalable, performant virtualization experience across the board. And then it became about, you know, cloud and hybrid cloud, and we partnered with our public cloud partners and created this notion of first party overall cloud services, as well as enabling this whole notion of a data fabric with data mobility. Well, AI is that net new wave across the board, and customers are looking for us to continue to innovate on their behalf to enable them to leverage AI initiatives. And that's exactly fundamentally what we're doing. How are we doing it? In multiple different ways. Helping customers just be able to seamlessly have the right infrastructure with all of the enterprise-grade capabilities, with hybrid multi-cloud capability, with all of the cybersecurity capabilities built in. That's just, you know, helping them get their data AI ready and to accelerate their AI initiatives. I'll also mention that, you know, what's super exciting is that we recognize that different customers are at different stages of their AI initiatives. Some are in POC stage, some are in production deployment stage. So we are putting all of the value of AFX, AI Data Engine, and making it available as a service via NetApp Keystone for our customers. This way, whether they're in POC stage production deployment, it's seamless. They can adopt, scale, and accelerate their AI initiatives, and they can seamlessly scale with NetApp Keystone. That's all on everything that we're building for customers to be able to help them with their AI initiatives. But as you touched upon, behind the scenes, we're obviously leveraging AI internally in our own products in terms of continuing to give them the most secure storage on the planet. This is where it comes into real-time ransomware detection. It's not about detecting hours to days later. It is about making detection in primary storage within seconds to minutes, and then being able to inform the necessary security teams and enable rapid recovery from that standpoint.
Yeah, that's what got my attention, the rapid recovery, the ability to test, the automation. I mean, those are exactly what you know, end users are telling us they want to see as capabilities. And they're actually very much more likely to purchase a solution that does that. That's what they've also told us. So I think you're spot on. So clearly what we're seeing is the evolution, candidly, from storage to really data services, if I were to summarize. Thinking about that, how does that enable an organization, whether a government organization, public, private, doesn't matter, to be more agile? How do you see that playing out? Because you're really moving the ball now to a different conversation. You're talking to the business.
Absolutely. So if you look at it, basically, a lot of the enterprises are evolving to basically being that internal service providers, or whether it's government entities at their scale, they're also operating as a service provider across the board. That first level of flexibility comes into enabling customers to build a unified data foundation, collapse silos across the different application workloads. What does that enable for customers? Be able to get a consistent set of management, consistent automation. So I don't have to retrain, I can overcome talent shortages and skills gaps. Tied to that, it's consistent data security model. Otherwise, with inconsistent data security models, your weakest link basically compromises you. You also get consistent overall operational recovery workflows. Last thing you want is in a disaster situation is for the administrators to be fumbling around with the recovery workflows. Here, with a unified data foundation, it's that consistency that's built in. And then fundamentally, consistent experience across on-prem and cloud. Customers want to unlock that flexibility and the agility of being able to balance their application workloads, whether on-premises or in the cloud, and NetApp uniquely is enabling that for our customers. There's a level of simplicity at scale that is achieved with that, with this unmatched flexibility, both at the workload level as well as the data level. And then when you talked about data services, this is about just continuing to deliver what customers need to be able to have the workload integrated data management services. So when you think about mission critical application workloads running on database applications and getting right. application consistent overall backup copies of data that they can have and instantly be able to recover in an application consistent manner, that's flexibility, but that's also safety and security for customers because it's bread and butter for them.
Right, I mean, AI will create more data. You have to protect the data, that's the source for AI. You have to create the protect the models, you have to protect the metadata, and you're gonna have to protect the data from the agents talking to other agents to demonstrate causality, et cetera, et cetera. So, yeah, it's a very nice story.
If I can take that one step further, I mean, that's just a wonderful segue, and what George talked about in the keynote is when you expand that and you look at your entire data set and you transform it, you vectorize it, you can develop the graph databases as well. And ultimately, when you think about and fast forward to agentic AI, that metadata fabric layer becomes so critically important to apply that structure over unstructured data and then have essentially a knowledge graph that can be that interface point, that where all of your data has been classified and curated and guardrails are available, and it gives you access only to the right set of agents with the right context of the data.
Right.
We see that as just a tremendous forward-looking opportunity.
Yeah. And that's how you create trust in data, and for agentic AI it will be key. Real quick, how do you see the future from a data infrastructure perspective?
Look, the future is bright. Every organization, every customer is in the process of how do they continue to modernize their infrastructure. That modernization, certainly AI is a major trigger point for customers, but so is cyber resilience, all right? Virtualization strategies customers are exploring. So there's many different areas that are leading to customers to say, I don't need to just refresh, I need to be thoughtful. I need to build the right data foundation that helps me modernize at the same time. And that, you know, having that right data foundation is where we see the opportunity with the NetApp data platform. Customers can onboard in terms of, you know, building a unified data platform or foundation with them. They can leverage cloud services or storage as a service. They can get cyber resilient. And, you know, that ultimately leads them to getting their data AI ready.
Excellent. Well, Sandeep, thank you so much. We've covered a lot of ground, very exciting time. Congratulations on the announcements. You're going to be very busy for the next few quarters, I believe.
Well, thank you, Christophe. This is just a fantastic opportunity. We're super excited. We're very much looking forward to continuing to work with our customers and our partners.
Great. Well, thank you so much. And to our viewers, thank you so much for being here with us. At NetApp INSIGHT 2025, my name is Christophe Bertrand, Principal Analyst with theCUBE Research, and we'll be right back, so please stay tuned.